Hey, everybody. I'm just hanging out at the house tonight. It's a rainy night here in Zephyr Hills, Florida. I'm just playing around with my guitar, playing around with some songs, and I thought I'd try this Facebook Online thing and see what happens. So, yeah, I'm just going to play a few of my little songs that I do at my gigs, and we shall see how this goes. Let's see. Any of my friends out there this evening? Just hanging around at the house as well. Let me see if I see anybody pop on here. Maybe. All right. I'll just start singing a little bit and maybe I'll see y'all join me.
Playing some birds and rocks and things. They were saying if it was
it's a Friday night. It's a rainy Friday night. Just hanging out here at the house. Thought I'd sing a little bit. Thought I'd try out this Facebook Live stuff and see how it goes. Hey there, Matt and Barbara and Angela and my Aunt Sherry. Woot woot, how y'all doing tonight? Good to see you on here. Hey, I think I figured it out. You know, this technology stuff, it can be a little bit of a challenge. Anyway, let's see what else I got up in here for y'all. People smile and tell me I'm the lucky one, and you just begun. I think I'm gonna have a son. He will be like she and me, as free as a bird. Come see to me. The sun is gonna shine above. Tonight, and I thought, let's try this Facebook Live thing and see how it goes. So here's where we're at. So hopefully some of y'all out there will like Jimmy Buffett. If I can find the track here. Here we go. One of my favorite Jimmy Buffett songs. Jimmy Buffett there, y'all. Woot woot. Hey there, Maxine. How you doing tonight, hon? Good to see you. You and Patty and Robin. Howdy, y'all. Woot woot. Welcome. Welcome to my living room, everybody. So I'm just hanging out, singing a few tunes. Get a swig of my Pepsi. This next one's always been a favorite of mine, and I do it just about every time I sing out and about somewhere. A little bit of Georgia Zone, R.E.M.
Mm-hmm.
Just hanging out and singing a little bit. Thought I'd see who might join me. Who else is home on a Friday night with all this rain? Oh my gosh, I'm over the rain. I'm ready for fall. I'm sick of the heat. And I'm sick of the rain. I'm sick of mosquitoes. Mostly the mosquitoes, let me tell you. They are not my friend. I wish they would suck fat instead of blood. But I might like them. But hey, you know, just saying. So this next one, a lot of people have covered this song, and I love, love, love it, and I hope that you will enjoy it too.
Thank you.
One that I always love doing. It's by The Cure. I think it might be from the 80s, I think. I do a lot of 70s and 80s stuff. I do classic rock, southern rock, yacht rock, soft rock, country and pop, pretty much from the 70s to today. And you're getting a little glimpse of what I do when I'm singing out and about in various restaurants and whatnot. I'll sing wherever they'll have me. So, heck yeah, hope you make it to a show sometime soon. This week I will be, Sunday, I will be up at Backwater Fins up in Crystal River. It's a super fun little place if you've never been. Take a nice little Sunday afternoon drive and enjoy some seafood and a little taste of old Florida. The staff there and the scenery is so peaceful and tranquility perfect. Very sadly, I have lost my Saturday regular gig over in Clearwater at a little restaurant. They are struggling really bad financially, and so they have had to put music on hold. So that was a wah, wah, wah. That's very sad. But hopefully something else will take its place. I'm a firm believer of trying to stay positive. If one door closes, maybe another door will open for you. Hopefully. Fingers crossed. So here's a little bit of The Cure for you. Put that on do not disturb so that doesn't happen again. Sometimes I forget to do that, and then it'll shoot stuff through to me. I'm like, oh no, what happened? So this next one, I have a buddy of mine back from Tennessee, and he would fill in once in a blue moon for me whenever my regular guitar players, Jeff Bradley, Charlie Luker, whenever they were not available, this fellow would fill in. He filled in a handful of times for us when I had a gig and I didn't want to cancel the gig and I didn't want to lose the gig. And so I'd reach out to him, and if he was free, he would come over and he would sing with me. And it's so wild to think that I can say I knew him when. And I used to always tease him about that years back. He went off and won season 17 of The Voice. If you are not familiar with who I'm speaking of, please check him out. His name is Jake Hoot. Woot woot for the hoot. Season 17 winner of The Voice. Super sweet fella. It was awesome to see him win and go off and get to pursue his dreams. So super, super cool. But him and I played at a winery up in Tennessee. It was for a private event they had going on. And we had a request from the audience for this next song. I think it was the first time it was ever released was back in 1948 by Pee Wee King. But everybody and their brother has covered this song. Let's see, Patti Page, Connie Francis, Emmylou Harris, Anne Murray, Elvis, Patsy Cline. So yeah, like I said, everybody has covered this song. And after we sang it that night, and we had never sang it before together, he's like, you need to add that one to your set list. And so I did, and I have been singing it ever since. And it's always a crowd favorite, especially with our elderly generation, because I think it steps back a little bit into their realm. But it's a great old country song, and I hope that you will enjoy it too. It's called Tennessee Waltz. I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee Waltz when an old friend I happened to see. I introduced her to my loved one, and while they were dancing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember the night and the Tennessee Waltz. Now I know just how much I have lost. Oh yes, I lost my little darling the night they were playing the beautiful Tennessee Waltz. I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee Waltz. What an old friend I happened to see. I introduced her to my loved one, and while they were dancing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember the night and the Tennessee Waltz. Now I know just how much I have lost. Oh yes, I've lost my little darling the night they were playing the beautiful Tennessee Waltz. I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee Waltz when an old friend I happened to see. I introduced her to my loved one, and while they were dancing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember the night pretty little tune. Such a pretty song. One of my all-time favorites. Of course, the version I'm most familiar with is probably Anne Murray, my mother. I have such a huge eclectic music appreciation from listening to different things with my grandmothers and my mom and dad. They had their own preferences. My dad was a big CCR, Bob Seger. He liked those grovelly voices. And then my mother had Dean Martin and Elvis and Anne Murray records. And then I had all the stuff that I grew up with too, you know, like Styx and Foreigner and the Eagles. The Eagles are probably one of my all-time favorites. And the Beatles and so much good music. So much good music everywhere, right? Everywhere you go. Let me see what else I have in here for y'all. Oh, this one will be a good one. I think you'll enjoy.
Tequila sunrise, hey Kelly, staring so weird.
Sitting around and playing some songs, and I thought, you know what, I'm gonna try this live thing. So if you're just joining me, that's the first time you've heard that. If you've been on here the whole time, I'm sorry that you've heard it a couple times. So the Eagles has always been one of my favorites, and I always do several of theirs in my sets, in my shows. Fleetwood Mac, and of course Stevie Nicks. My heart. Love my Stevie, and I always incorporate some of her music as well. And do you know this next song that I'm going to do by them? This was their only number one hit. What? What? Fleetwood Mac only had one number one, and it was this next song, and Stevie wrote it. Some of the songs that they had most success with, the girls wrote. And they were actually known as a British rock band, only because they had one more British member than they had Americans. So three Brits and two Americans. Sadly, they lost Christy McVie not too long ago, which is sad. But anyway, this is probably one of my all-time favorite songs of theirs, and I'll get to it.
Freedom, but who am I to give you? Shining down like water.
next one. It is by Ashley Monroe of the Pistol Annies, if you're not familiar with who she is. Very, very, very cool song. I've always loved this song. Actually, a buddy of mine from the Homosassa area, when there was three or four of us that were trying to get a little band put together up there, suggested this song to me, and I had never heard it before that point in time. And gave it a listen, and I threw it into my set list, and it's been there ever since. And I hope you will enjoy it as much as I do. I wish I would lay my hands on you. Katie Lang song. It's called called Constant Craving. Plug it in. Let's see. with me, y'all. Hopefully I don't make everything come apart here.
That would be bad.
There.
I think I got it. Woot.
All right, quick and painless. Let's see, I got a couple more in here for you that I'll try to do before I log off for the night. Let's see. So yeah, it's just a rainy Friday night, and I was bored. And I thought I would sit here and go through a few of my songs. For those of you who maybe haven't been to a show and would like to come to a show and just haven't been out, I know some people don't like to come to places where there's alcohol. I understand that. So yeah, I thought I'd do a few of the songs that I usually do on my shows for y'all. This next one is a crowd pleaser as well. I like to dig back into the cobwebs, and even, you know, I've played with a lot of musicians, and they're always like, oh, that's a $100 song, or that's a $50 song, or that's a $20 song, just because they're tired of doing it. To me, if somebody wants to hear it, buddy, let them hear it, you know? Is it really going to kill you? They're there anyway. You're getting paid to be up there to sing, so just don't have that attitude. It runs all over me, please. anyway, I always just like to give the people what they want. Let them hear what they want to hear. Situation. I'll be reaching out to them. Lately these days it seems like mostly what I get hit up for is karaoke hosting and solo stuff. And I'm sure we're all feeling that pinch of how expensive everything is nowadays, and they just don't want to pay for a full band. But one of these days we will get up there on that stage. We will do it. We do a mix of country, pop, classic rock, southern rock, yacht rock. I do a little bit of everything from the 70s to today, whether that's in my band or whether that's with my duo partners or as a solo. So this next one is another one that I've been doing for many, many, many years, and it's one of my favorites. It's a little Nancy Sinatra for y'all. Oh, I forgot my little foot tambourine. Shoot.
You keep a saying you got something for me, something you call love but confess. You've been a messin' aware you shouldn't have been a messin', oh yeah. And now someone else is getting all your best. And these boots may be walking, and that's just what they'll do. These days, these boots are gonna walk all over you. Better look out. You keep a lying when you ought to be a truthin', and you keep a losing when you ought to know that. You keep a saying when you ought to be a changing, oh yeah. Though what's right is right, but
it's a really cool old video with them in their little go-go boots dancing all around and singing to that one. It's pretty sexy too, if I must say so myself. I was like, wow. So, heck yeah. I think I need a capo for this one. Feel free to play along with me. Sing along with me. Grab your guitar, Rick, and play from your couch. Let's see. I think everybody probably knows this next one, but what's funny is, I bet 90 to 95% of the people do not know the original people who recorded this song. It is not Darius Rucker, by the way, and that probably just gave it away. And I'm not talking about him with Hootie and the Blowfish. I'm talking about the country side of things. So see if anybody can type into me. I know you're gonna Google that shit. But tell me who is the original for this next song.
Well, I made it down the coast.
Darius Rucker, for those who don't know the original. Nobody typed in who the original was. Wow. Old Crow Medicine Show. That was the originals. Those are the original people who recorded it. Darius covered it, obviously. But, yeah. Everybody's probably more familiar with Darius's version. I think I might got like two or three more in here in my little fingertips. And then I'll call it. But thank you for being here tonight. Thanks for popping into my living room and hanging out with me for a little bit as I sing a few songs that I usually sing out and about places. Come join me Sunday afternoon up in Crystal River, Ozella, as they call it. Part of Nature's Coast. It's a nice little Sunday drive, and I sing early. I don't sing late. I'm there from 2 to 5. So you could drive on up, have a late lunch, hang out with me, get to soak in some of the old Florida views. There's no traffic up that way. I love it about going that way. Plus, I just love the people up there. I love the venue. I love the food. I love the scenery. The whole experience is one that I think you'll truly enjoy. So come and join me on Sunday afternoons up there. Backwater Fins is the name of the restaurant, seafood restaurant. And I'd love to see you. This next one is one of my favorites. Some of you might remember it from a movie. I think it was Reservoir Dogs. Kind of a gruesome scene in the movie. But I just love this song.
Mm-hmm.
couple of Rhonda friends on here actually right now. I think I have three. I know three Rhondas. What? Help me, Rhonda. Help me, Rhonda. I might have to add that one to my mix. Let's see what else I got in here. Oh, this is a good old tune. I love this one. I used to do it with my fellas back in Tennessee, my Saudi Daisy band group up there. Jeff Bradley on the Telecaster guitar. He's a guitar picker. One of the best I've ever played with, actually, probably the best I've ever played with. And then Charlie Hooker. Oh man, that guy can play everything, and he's a singer and a songwriter. He's super talented group of guys back there. Gosh, I miss singing with them every week. Barry Barkley was always on drums for us, and he used to twirl the sticks behind me, and I never knew that till Montana caught it one or two times in some videos, and I was like, oh my gosh, look at Barry. He goes, I know, that stuff you don't see when you're standing in front of him singing. I'm like, holy crap. And Lauren Bandy, our bass player, gosh, cannot forget him. Oh, I love all his stories. That man has played music his whole life. He's played with some really big names, and I think he's writing music now for Netflix and Amazon Prime type shows. He writes a lot of the music, so some of those movies and shows that you might be watching could be written by my good buddy, Lauren Bandy, and he also has a bluegrass band, and they were IMEA Band of the Year, Bluegrass Band of the Year a couple times in a row back when I was in Tennessee. I'd have to look it up and see what years that was, but him and Charlie were both in that band. Charlie was his fiddle player, easy for me to say. And Lauren played an upright bass, beautiful old upright bass, beautiful thing. But those guys, oh my gosh, such a talented group. And we used to always do this next song. And I love their version. We always gave it kind of a bluesy feel, if you will. This track doesn't have as bluesy of a feel as how we used to do it, but it's still a cool old song, and I hope you remember it and enjoy it. It was the 3rd of June, another sleepy, dusty Dale today. I was out chopping cotton, and my brother was baling hay. At dinner time, we stopped and walked back to the house to eat. And Mama hollered out the back door, "Y'all remember to wipe your feet." She said, "I got some news this morning from Choctaw Ridge. Today, Billy Joe McAllister's jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge." Papa said to Mama as he passed around those black-eyed peas, "But Billy Joe never had a lick of sense as the biscuits, please." There was a virus going round in 4 days. I got to plow. Whoops. And Mama said it was a shame about Billy Joe. Anyhow, it seems like nothing ever comes to no good up on Choctaw Ridge. And now you're telling Billy Joe is jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge. Well, brother recollected when he had told him Billy Joe, they put a frog down the back at the Carroll County Picture Show. Wasn't I talking to him after church last Sunday night? I'll have another piece of apple pie. You know it don't seem right. I saw him at the sawmill yesterday up on Choctaw Ridge. You tell me Billy Joe has jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge. Well, Mama said to me, "Child, what's happened to your appetite?" Well, I've been cooking all morning, and you have and she and Billy Joe was throwing something off the Tallahatchie Green. A year's come and gone since we heard the news about Billy Joe. Brother Mary, Becky Thompson, and they brought a story to a low. There was a virus going round, Papa caught it and he died last spring. And now Mama doesn't seem to want to do much of anything. And me, I spend a lot of time picking flowers up on Chocorini and dropping them into that muddy water on the Tallahatchie Bridge. Had a boogie that went along with it. Do you remember it? Roddy Benson. Oof. Talk about eye candy. Heck yeah. Let me see. Let me go up to some of the newer stuff I've been working on. See what I got in there before I call it a night show. Alright, I'm going to try this next one. Don't judge me if I don't get it exactly quite right, because I'm still working on it a little bit. But Badfinger, so I've always loved the groups with tons of harmony, like the Eagles, the Beatles, Alabama, Zac Brown Band, all those bands and all those harmonies, America. Just love, 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 cannot get my fill of harmony songs. Badfinger was also one of the groups in that mix that I just absolutely loved, love, love, loved. Very sad story with that band. If you're not familiar, look it up sometime. Two of them committed suicide, not at the same time, years apart. But they kind of got the shaft in the music industry, as so many talented people do. And very, very, very sadly, they took their lives over it, I guess. But anyway, here's one of their songs that I've always loved. I'm still working on it, so it's not perfect yet. But it's fun, and I think you'll hopefully enjoy it.
Thank you.
super, super cool. I think I need to do this other Eagles one, what I've been working on. I've got several in my set list by the Eagles because they are my all-time favorites. This is a newer one to me, not new to me, but newer for me to play and sing. So I've been singing probably pretty much since I could walk and talk, is what my mother will tell you. But the guitar and the instruments, now I played keyboard for a small amount of time. My grandmother played piano by ear, and all of us used to gather around, my mom's mom. And she was gifted that way. She could play anything by ear, super talent. Don't hate me, musician friends, but I just kind of feel like maybe some of those people who play by ear, they might be just a little more talented because they don't need the sheet music in front of them. Now, I'm not saying that there's no talent involved with sheet music. There is, so please don't read that wrong. I'm not bashing either side, but I just feel like people who can play anything just by hearing it, oh my goodness, that is amazing to me. And so when I was younger, maybe wasn't quite a teenager yet, my mom asked my grandmother, what do you think? Should I give her lessons? And I wanted a piano. I wanted a piano so stinking bad. But my dad got my mom an organ, and she played organ in the church. And so we didn't have room in our home for both, so we had an organ. So then one year for Christmas, they got me a keyboard. It wasn't what I wanted, though. I wanted a piano so bad. But anyway, for a good chunk of my life in between there with church years and whatnot, I did play that. And all of my life, I wanted to play guitar, and I haven't even really fully been playing it for a year yet. I'm a rhythm player. I'm not a picker. I admire deeply all of my music friends who can do that. They are talented beyond belief. And drummers, oh my gosh, that's the one instrument I don't know how they do it. There's so much going on. Keep in time. Hit this drum, hit that drum. Oh my God, I suck at drums. But ukulele is what kind of finally made it all click. And I'm so happy for that. And I wish I would have had the internet and YouTube at my disposal when I was a teenager. Oh my gosh, then I would have been so much further ahead than where I am now. But I'm a late learner in life for the guitar, but love it to pieces. I'm addicted to it and I can't get enough of it. And this is one that I have recently learned to play on the guitar by the Eagles. Doing harmony on this. It's hard for me not to do that. all-time favorite group. Yes, yes, yes. I know I keep saying just a couple more.
I keep seeing others that I want to do. And I guess, you know, I'll just be sitting here singing probably tomorrow morning when y'all wake up. No, just kidding. Let's see. This next one. I want to do it. I've been working on this one too. I've added like 12 new songs. I'm constantly adding new songs. I am not one of those people who is satisfied just doing the same group of songs again and again and again and again. I am constantly screenshotting songs when I'm driving. Ooh, that'd be a good song. Let me look that one up, see if I can play it. Ooh, that's a cool song. It's amazing my phone still works, actually. So, I bet you I have an Excel spreadsheet, and it probably goes on for 10 miles of songs I want to add yet. Constantly adding songs. And then wherever I'm singing, I just kind of go off either my mood or the crowd. I kind of see what they respond to, and if they respond to certain songs, then I kind of stay within that realm and build as I go. Any gig that you ever come to, you'll never see me do the same stuff all the time. There are a few songs that I will do every gig, just because they're tried and true and everybody loves them, and I know that they'll get a good response. But then I also like to mix it up, and I throw in different songs. All the time, constantly. But this one I used to go every year, and I think Rhonda, Colorado Rhonda. I don't know if you went with me when we went to Westfest down Copper Mountain, Michael Martin Murphy's Westfest. That was always really cool. Saw Susie Boggess out there one year and saw him. And this next one is one of his songs that I've always loved, and I think y'all will know it when you hear it.
She ran calling wildfire.
such a pretty, pretty song. I should just stop playing and let the piano part do its thing. Pretty, pretty song. Always loved that one. So this next one, y'all, I always thought Dr. Hook did this one. So I always learn things as I look up songs to chart. And I love, like I said earlier, digging through the cobwebs of my brain and coming up with songs that you don't hear out and about all the time. I like to come up with different things. I don't want to be a carbon copy of anybody. And I never try to imitate any of these artists. Please don't ever think I'm trying to be them. I would never, never. Those are huge shoes to fill, and I just do this because I love it and I enjoy it. But I would never, ever try to be any of those people. They are, every single one of them, awesome in their own right. I put my own twist, my own spin on everything I sing, so I would never, ever want to try to sound. And you're setting yourself up for failure if you're trying to sound like the original anyway. But this next song I discovered was not a Dr. Hook song. In fact, they never even covered it or recorded it. I'm like, what? So it was by a British rock band called Smokey. And I'm surprised that it never went to number one in the U.S. It did in the U.K. and it did in several other countries. But I think it made it to, if I can read my little notes here that I made to myself, I think it was like top 25 or something like that here in the United States. But yeah, in Austria, Germany, Ireland, Norway, the Netherlands, Switzerland, it was number one. It was number two in Australia for 23 weeks. But yep, I always thought this song was by Dr. Hook, and I learned it is not. So I hope you'll remember it, and I hope you'll enjoy it. I like the storytelling stuff too. Aside from the harmonies.
Sally called and she got the word, and she said, I suppose you've heard about Alice. Well, I rushed to the window and I looked outside. I could hardly believe my eyes. It was simple. And Alice is dry. Well, I don't know why she's leaving or where she's gonna go. I guess she's got her reasons, but I just don't wanna know. 'Cause for 24 years I've been living next door to Alice. 24 years just waiting.
y'all. That was a band called Smokey that had that one out. Never Dr. Hook, as I always thought my whole life. What? Who knew? Let's see. This was another fun storytelling one. I love putting a lot of personality into this one. And if you're not familiar with it, just listen to the lyrics. It's kind of funny. And I hope you will enjoy it. It's from the early 70s, and it's by Bobby Bear, and it's called Marie Laveau.
Let it. show of surprise when Mrs. Johnson wore that miss skirt into the room. And as she walked up to the blackboard, I can still recall the words she had to say. She said, "I'd like to address this meeting of the Hartford Valley PTA." Well, there's Bobby Taylor sitting there, and several times he's asked me for a date. And Mrs. Taylor sure seems to use a lot of ass whenever he's away. And Mr. Baker, can you tell us why your secretary had to leave this town? And shouldn't Widow Jones be told to keep her window shades on full completely down?
Actually wrote that song based on some true facts. So yeah, I think we've all been around some of those people that like to tell everybody else how to live and what to do. Mind your business. Right, all right, one more, y'all, and I'm gonna call it a night. And this is an old tune by Rod Stewart that I've always loved, and I've seen a lot of bands cover it over the years, and I'm gonna give it my own little twist. Here's Maggie May.
Late.
again for being with me, hanging out, and watching the Ferrari little comments that I saw pop up. Thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Makes my heart smile big and huge and proud. Thank you. So heck yeah, I might do this again soon. So be watching for any live posts, and I hope you enjoyed it. And if you think of any songs that maybe I have not forgot, that I have not remembered, that would be a good mix for what I do, please shoot them to me. Send me a PM or shoot me a text or let me know. Say, hey, LaWanda, what about this song? Or whatever. Have a good night, everybody. Thanks for being here. I'll catch you next time. Be safe.